Miriam, and welcome to the Ministry. You remember in my previous video, I posted on how we should contemplate country living, and you know, I specified some things you need to consider when you are pondering for country living. And in the meantime, as you are preparing for that, as you are investing in your website, you know, you can also find something that you can do in the city. This is just temporarily, because we know that eventually, if you are, your water is to be switched off because you don't comply with the rules and regulations of your town council or with the state, I think as we see things are changing, you may not be able to have such things. So at the end of the day, this is just something that is temporary that you can do. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you put the chicken manure into the plants. I've received some requests on how do you do that without damaging the plants. Because many that have applied it, they realize that when they put the chicken manure in the plants, it's very strong. It tend to bend their plants, especially if you are growing in pots. So you need to do it with care, and you need to be very careful so that you don't end up bending all your plants. So this is what we're going to be doing today. With me, I have my tools, I have my small shovel, hand shovel, that I'm going to use. Of course, I'm going to need my mask, and I'm wearing my gloves because the manure itself is very strong, and therefore I need to cover my nose a little bit because it's a little bit smelly and very strong because it still contains some, you know, some chicken urine and all that. But you know, the plants need all these things. Yeah, so today we are just going to be putting more in the greens, that is the vegetables. We are not going to put more on the tomatoes. We have the tomatoes here. You can see the tomatoes, you can see also the eggplants. So we are not going to be putting in the eggplants. These are preparing because the eggplants, if you put more of nitrogen, you end up having more roots and without having flowers. So currently they are going into flower. They already started making flowers, so we don't want to disrupt that. We also see that the tomatoes, they are also going into flowers, so we don't want to add too much nitrogen in it because nitrogen tends to give you more than that. So you realize that when you're using, you know, this non-organic fertilizer, the what they call NPK, you need to check at the ratios which is indicated there. But I prefer to go the organic way of using the natural things. Even those that are using fertilizer, the normal one that you buy, you realize that they indicate to say how much of the nitrogen is there and how much of the potassium and phosphorus that is there and
pressure.
The plants need. So at the end of the day, this is what we're going to be doing here. Therefore, we are going to put only in the greens which do not bear much of the fruits. We are going to leave out these other ones. For now, for these ones, we need to look for something that encourages the flowers. We are going to use the Epsom salt, but not today. But that will be in the later stage where we can add Epsom salt to it. Because Epsom salt actually encourages the plants to bear more fruits. So for now, we are going to start. So kindly follow with me as we do the things, as we start the juice.